Since I was a child, I've always had a burning desire to sing. I just didn't know how. But when I was 19, I attended a lecture on singing that would change my life. And on that night, a woman told the audience that if you can speak and if you can breathe, then you can learn to sing. I believed there was finally hope. And I began practicing for 5 hours every single day. I then found a teacher, and she believed in me so much, she trained me for over 10 years until the very day that she died. And she happened to be an opera singer. And over the next few years, as my voice grew stronger and stronger, I won many leading roles in the great classic musicals. But I still wanted to stage my own shows. Years later, I met a producer who recognized a potential in my voice, and we began work on an album that would lead me to be signed by one of the biggest record labels in the world, EMI Music. And my album Cry for Love was released, a dream come true. Since then, I've performed in the United States with some of the best singers in the world. I sung the national anthem in Australia to almost 1 billion people on live television and built and staged my own orchestra shows. Then from these shows, I noticed a lot of Indian people were attending my concerts, which was wonderful. It brought a sense of pride to our community, and it gave our youth something they could aspire to. So now I want to fuse my classical background with Indian instrumentation in the songs that I sing, to create something different, something new, something that's never been heard before. I want to serve the world by uplifting people and bringing them joy through my singing. And through my concerts, I am able to unite cultures, bringing Eastern and Western cultures together to share and appreciate their common values and nurture trust between them. This is the power of music. And I want to invite you to become part of the story, to inspire and to serve the world.
My heart is held up in your heart.